Hey, it's Shadow ACS again. Today I'll be taking a look at a little underground independent show that no one in the anime community has probably ever heard of before. Except the 275 billion people who've requested me to review it. This is Attack on Titan. Okay, before anyone asks, yes, this show's opening is easily the best I've ever seen. I know that might seem like a weird thing to bring up right away, but this show's opening theme has gotten almost as big a reputation as the show itself, and for good reason. Anyway, Attack on Titan. In the past several months, this show has taken the entire anime community by storm, becoming one of the most popular anime of all time almost overnight. And I gotta say, at first, I was just as blown away by it as everybody else. The action was amazing, the drama was genuine, it had memorable characters, outstanding music, an addictive story. But as I got further and further into this show, I started to notice more and more problems. And sad to say, my complaints with this show do go beyond just minor nitpicks. There were times when I wanted to freaking punch this anime. Now before any of you go nuts, I do think this is a really good show. The good stuff in it is not only amazing, it's some of the best I've seen in any anime. But it also has a couple things I really freaking hate about it, which is why it didn't quite make it onto my favorites list. But it's still a good show, and I was more than happy to see it, and I'll definitely watch the second season when it comes out. Okay, so what's the show about? Attack on Titan takes place in a dystopian world where humanity is nearly extinct. 100 years prior to the story, giant humanoid monsters called Titans seemingly appeared out of nowhere and devoured most of the human race. A small faction of humanity was able to save itself by building a system of colossal walls to keep the Titans out. Now humans have grown accustomed to living within the walls and are more or less convinced that life can go on like this forever. Everyone, that is, except for our main character, a boy named Eren Yeager. He's always been fascinated by tales of the world outside the walls and dreams of one day being able to see it for himself. One day, a massive Titan appears outside humanity's outermost wall and smashes through it, causing an army of Titans to swarm in and devour the people inside, including Eren's mother, who Eren was forced to watch get eaten alive right before his eyes. As Eren and his friends narrowly escape to one of the inner walls, Eren makes a vow to exterminate every last Titan in existence. The three friends decide to join the military, and thus the story unfolds. The kids grow up several years during their training, Eren discovers a dark secret about himself, there's plot twists, giant action scenes, all sorts of great action-adventure stuff. Okay, so what's good about Attack on Titan? Obviously a show that gets this popular has to have at least something good about it. The one thing about this show that immediately caught my attention was just the size of it. No pun intended. This is easily one of the most epic anime I have ever seen. The action, well, do I even need to comment? Just look at it! This is hands down the best animation I have ever seen in any anime. I don't know who the animation team that worked on this was, but they need to do more shows. But it's not just the action that makes the show so large and epic, the story is a big contributor as well. It's humanity's last stand as it fights against extinction. And practically everything that happens in this show feels incredibly large and groundbreaking because there's always so much to be lost. Not just the lives of the characters, but the entire human race. If you want to watch an anime just for the epic factor, this is at the top of the list of shows I'd recommend. But that's not the only factor that contributes to the show's quality, there's also the characters. And the character cast in this show is good, but not perfect. Eren, I actually think, is a really good main character. Especially considering that half the main characters in anime coming out nowadays are so generic and bland that they might as well be made of cardboard. What really separates Eren from the rest of the main characters out there is his anger. His goal isn't to save lives or protect humanity or something generic like that, it's to murder every last Titan in existence. Which is much more passionate and interesting than wanting to save the innocent who gives a crap that we see in every other main character. Eren is dark, moody, and has a tendency to blow up in people's faces, but it's justified because of what he's had to go through. Throughout the entire show, he always has vengeance for his mother in the back of his mind and thinks nothing of putting his life in terrible danger to get it. But he still cares for the people close to him enough that you still want to side with him. I'd be lying if I said I thought Eren was on par with, say, Lelouch or Ed Elric as a main character, but he's definitely one of the better ones I've seen. The other two main characters are Eren's childhood friends, a girl named Mikasa and a boy named Armin. Mikasa is probably the best character in the entire show. When I first saw her, I remember thinking, oh great, this is gonna be the generic love interest character, they're gonna start off as friends, gradually fall in love throughout the course of the show, I got this all figured out. But one of the best things about Attack on Titan is just how unpredictable it is. Mikasa's relationship with Eren isn't really love as much as sort of a dark obsession mixed with friendship. It's kind of hard to describe in words without giving away her backstory. Throughout the show, her only primary interest seems to be just keeping Eren alive. And there's a sense that if he were to die, she would lose all sense of purpose. Mikasa is one of the strongest and by far the most badass character in the show, and she sort of draws that strength from Eren's passion and anger. It's a really complex and kind of psychological relationship when you think about it. I'm sure this doesn't make a lot of sense to people who haven't seen the show, but trust me, it's her great backstory that makes it all come together. Armin is also a really good character. Like with Mikasa, I was a little worried when I first saw him. He's set up as this smart, outcasted kid who's not physically strong but can always keep his head during a crisis. I guess I was a little worried he would turn out to be sort of this gimmicky nerd character, or maybe like Soul from Soul Eater, where they keep telling us he has one character trait without actually conveying it. But, as it turns out, Armin is very intelligent. Some of the plans and ideas he comes up with are so inventive that you actually want to be smarter while watching him. I also like how they don't make Armin too smart. He's still a normal kid, not some crazy super genius who can figure out everything without even trying. My only complaint with Armin is that he does seem a little more one-dimensional than Eren or Mikasa. Aside from just being an inventive, out-of-the-box thinker, there's really not a whole lot to him. But to be honest, I still think that's enough to make him a good character. So with three great main characters in this show, what is it about this cast that I don't like? Well, my problem is with the show's side characters. And don't get me wrong, there are good side characters in this show. I especially like some of the military commanders that show up later in the anime. They're all their own unique flavor of intelligent and badass. But most of the side characters I don't think are nearly as memorable as they should have been. And I actually kind of feel bad for the show in this respect because it really seemed like it was trying to do something like Full Metal Alchemist, where they just have a ton of memorable side characters that all leave a huge impact. But I really don't think this show was that successful at it. This is one instance where I think the large epic nature of the show almost kind of works against it. It seems like almost every scene in this show has either a huge plot reveal or a giant action scene taking place, and there just isn't enough time to develop a large cast of characters. They work a few of them in okay, but most of them only get maybe 4 or 5 scenes to develop their identities. I can even remember a few scenes where characters die, and all I could think of was, okay, this is sad, I guess, but who the hell was this guy? Why do I care that he's dead now? And that's really a problem when you're so emotionally uninvested in the characters that you don't even care when one of them gets killed off. If you look at shows like High School of the Dead or Mare, even though they both have a lot of action in them, they also dedicate a ton of time to developing the characters. You see them interacting, you get a sense of their different personalities and how each of them feels about the others individually, and there's a really strong sense of camaraderie among them. I just didn't get that from Attack on Titan. And like I said before, I really do think the problem is that there just isn't enough time in a show like this to develop this many characters. Ultimately, what I think it comes down to is that the show needed to have either less action or less characters. I'm leaning towards less characters because the action in this show is part of what makes it stand out so much. But you can't expect us to care about individual characters when we've only had a couple scenes to get to know all of them. To give you an idea, if you asked me to name all the characters in, say, Full Metal Alchemist and give a brief description of each of their personalities, I could probably get most of them without too much trouble. With Attack on Titan, I'd be lucky to get maybe 7 or 8 of them, and that's including the main characters. But I don't think this is a fatal flaw with the anime or anything. I still think the show has a good character cast, again, largely on account of our three main leads. I just don't think the side characters are as memorable as they should have been. The story, I think, is both one of the best and worst aspects of this show. On one hand, it's addictive as hell. I rarely finished an episode of this anime not totally hyped to see what was going to happen next. And if the whole thing had been out when I first started watching it, I probably would have finished this anime in only a couple days. And I think part of what makes it so addictive is, again, just how unpredictable it is. This show has a real fetish for plot twists, and all of them work. I was only able to guess 1 or 2 of the twists in this show, and even the ones I could predict got me hyped for what was going to happen. I also want to give props to this anime for how well it takes advantage of the whole end-of-the-world setup. Again, much like High School of the Dead, every moment of fear and panic in this show feels genuine. And the show establishes very early on that it is not afraid to show you what the stakes are. Attack on Titan is sometimes called the Game of Thrones of anime because of how grim and violent it is, and it's a pretty good analogy. Much like Game of Thrones, the brutal nature of the story combined with the amount of plot twists make it very difficult to stop watching. I have heard there's an argument that the story has pacing issues, specifically that the battles go on for way too long. And while it never bothered me that much, I can kinda see why it would get in the way for some viewers. But here's what I did have a problem with. The leadership of humanity in this show is headed by a fat, selfish king and a bunch of one-dimensional, rich aristocrats who don't care about anything except money in their own lives. Every time these guys showed up, I wanted to punch out my goddamn screen. First of all, is there anyone in the freaking world who likes this cliché? The stereotypical rich caviar-eating snob who goes around kicking puppies and poor people because the script needs to give us someone to hate? And I know it's supposed to be a social commentary about how people can't learn to work together even at the end of the world, which granted I do like the idea of in a show like this, but if you're gonna do social commentary or any kind of message for that matter, you have to be subtle about it if you want it to stick with the audience. Subtlety is the reason why the messages in movies like Citizen Kane and Fight Club are so powerful, while something like Fern Gully comes off like just a preachy piece of crap. And these stereotypical one-dimensional rich snobs are the absolute antithesis of subtlety. And I would actually be okay with these guys if they were just referenced as some minor thing that was happening in the background, and didn't really play a major role in the story. But there's a huge chunk of the story practically dedicated to these rich assholes shitting on Eren for something that, while I won't give away what it is pretty obviously a huge asset to humanity. Furthermore, setting up the human race as a bunch of self-destructive pricks just for the sake of a social commentary is completely unnecessary from a story point of view. Why? Because there's already a pretty obvious threat to humanity in this show. And the Titans are much more interesting because we know next to nothing about them and they're threatening for reasons other than they're just written like douchebags. Hell, if anything, having these guys be the leaders of humanity makes me actually want to see the Titans come in and squish their sorry asses. Yeah, that's right. For a good part of the story, this show had me totally siding with the Titans. Whether or not you like the anime, that is a terrible flaw with the story. But despite my hatred for this part of the setup, I do still recommend this show. While Attack on Titan does have enough problems that it didn't quite make it onto my top 30 list, I'm still really glad that I saw it. Like I said, the good stuff in it isn't just great, it's some of the best I have ever seen. The action is unbelievable, the story is impossible to stop watching, but like I said before, the best thing about Attack on Titan is just how freaking epic it is. If you want to watch an anime just to marvel at the sheer size and scope of it, this is definitely one to check out. And judging from what I know about my own personal tastes, I don't think the problems I had with it would bother other people quite as much as they did me. This is Shadow ACS, and I'll see you next time.